last night, I braided my slightly damp hair, and then I went to bed, and of course I slept. And then this morning, I'm going to take my hair out of this braid. Now, I do not ever braid my hair when it is sopping wet, very, very wet, because if I did, it would never get dry. But when it's slightly damp and I braid it, again, I get those wonderful waves that people are almost always commenting on. I say that if I don't get, you know, several people, strangers stop me in the street or the store during the week, then it's a bad hair week. Because my hair was in a braid, it has no tangles. It is dry now. Smells wonderful. And voila, the finished project. Product, not project. I guess growing your hair can be a project, but not in this case. And then this is what it looks like when it is released from the braid. Now, at this point, if I were to comb my hair, it would poof out. It would poof out even more if I brushed it. And when I say poof out, I'm talking about poodle hair, but poodle hair that is this long. And so I'm not going to comb it. I don't need to comb it. It has no tangles and it looks fine. Now, if you were to brush your hair, it would poof out even more. One of the reasons why is because a brush will create more static electricity than will a comb. And of course, we all know what static electricity does to our hair. By the way, if you have a problem with static electricity because of your hair, and I know I do, during the winter, I cringe when I go to touch metal. I use a product called Static Guard. And no, I don't spray my hair, but I spray my clothes, especially on my back when my hair's up, and that tends to cut back on the static. I talked about combing, I talked about washing hair. I don't use really expensive hair products on my hair, but I don't use the cheapest either. Yesterday when I washed my hair, I tried Dove shampoo and conditioner for the first time, and so I'm curious to see how that will work. But other than that, I usually use Fructis. I have used Pantene. I don't like Pantene as well as I do some of the other products, and I use a shampoo for damaged hair. Even though my hair is not really damaged, I want to ward off anything that I can in order to make it damaged and to keep it healthy. Now back to the trimming and the splittions, and I know that I have harped on this now incessantly, and some of these people have written on their videos or comments is that to them it doesn't serve a purpose to trim their hair because they want your hair to grow longer. If you have splittions and the ends of your hair are damaged, it's going to break. You are losing length anyway, and it makes it look poor. So why go that route? I just don't understand that, except that it must be ignorance. Also, keep in mind that your hair is going to grow to a certain length due to heredity and estrogen, but you don't absolutely have to have a lot of estrogen, because I don't have a lot of estrogen, but vitamins and minerals and eating a healthy diet. You need zinc for healthy hair. And eating a balanced diet will also promote healthy hair growth. Your hair is a reflection of your overall health. And people who have very poor nutrition usually do not have very healthy hair. Can't even think of a very poor nutrition, it would just go hand in hand. So make sure that you are eating right and getting enough sleep and you aren't stressed. Yes, stress will damage your hair. There's a whole lot of things that work together and combine to either make your hair long and beautiful or long and scraggly. And I bet that most people would want to go the route of long and beautiful rather than long and scraggly. I have also seen on some of these other videos where people have protested, despite the fact that their long hair looks bad, that they get compliments. Yeah, well, let me tell you something. I'm 58 years old, and I consistently have people tell me that I look 48. I don't. I look my age. People will compliment and fudge it a little bit, and long hair is an anomaly. When I go out in public, which I go out in public almost every single day, I do not see many people with hair as long as my hair. Sometimes I see people with hair that is longer than mine. Not very often. If it is a man with long hair, it is even more of an anomaly. And so people will remark on things that are out of the ordinary. And this is the reason why people are going to remark on your long hair and say that it's nice, but perhaps it could use a little bit of help. One more thing before I finish. If you need to wear your hair up, and I live in Missouri, and it was 105 and 106 degrees this summer, and I needed to put my hair up, I braid it again, and then I use these types of clips to keep it up. Sometimes, not all the time, I will take my hair and I will twist it and then put it up. And there is a really, 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 really good reason why I don't do that very often. And you already know what I'm going to say. It breaks your hair. I was living in California, and this had to have been, my gosh, 16, 17 years ago, and I had long hair. And while it was wet, I would twist it like that because when it dried, it looked absolutely gorgeous. Or if I had it in a ponytail, it would have this nice ringlet effect. And then I noticed that my hair started to thin. And I went to my hairdresser and I said, my hair seems to be thinning. And she felt it and she said, yeah. But then as she started to trim it, she said, you know, when I saw you in the store the other day and I complimented you on the way your hair was waving, and I said, yeah. She said, you're twisting it. And I said, yeah. And she said, it's breaking your hair. At my scalp, at the nape of my neck, my hair still had the same volume, but as you went further down the length of my hair, it had broken and it had become very thin. I had about that much cut off because I was willing to sacrifice that much hair in order for it to look healthy and be healthy. So if you twist your hair like that, do it only on occasion. And again, don't ever do it when your hair is wet. I don't do it for an effect. I only do it to get it off of my neck so that I can be cooler. Everything that you do works towards a healthy head of hair. Don't be one of those scraggly people. Boy, want to be one of those people who have long and gorgeous hair and don't have a lot of split ends. And you're going to have some regardless, but there's no need to have those ugly, scraggly ends when you simply don't have to. And by the way, if your hair reaches its optimum growing point and it won't go anymore, then accept that, get it trimmed, and move on.